I have previously published a video for the mini saw machine I designed. Now, I have made some important changes to the design to make it safer and more useful. The previous one had the on-off switch at the back. It was not very good in terms of safety and practical use. In the new version, I placed the push button on the handle. This allows it to be operated whenever needed, much safer and more practical. In the previous version, wide materials could be held in the correct position in the vise. But some of the narrow materials, such as pipes, were too close to the limit. And this could sometimes be a problem. In the new version, I designed a slide system to move the vise forward or backwards. In this way, materials of different widths can be in the correct position. I use smaller pulleys to increase the depth of cut. The previous version had 16 and 36 teeth pulleys. The depth of cut was 17 millimeters. In the new version, the motor pulley is the same as before, but I preferred a 32 teeth pulley for the blade shaft. As the pulley teeth decrease, the diameter becomes smaller. In this way, I was able to achieve a depth of cut of 20 millimeters. And finally, I added a trap for the dust flying back. Not completely, but it helps a little. Let's get started.
Thank you.
I had these parts of the vise printed with PETG. Since the metal heated up while being cut, the prolonged contact caused a small deformation, so I made some design changes. I stopped gluing these parts of the vise. I redesigned them so they could be screwed on for easy replacement. I also printed these three parts with ASA filament so they can be heat resistant. There were no heat-related problems with the parts I printed with ASA. Aluminum and brass types of metals can be cut without any problems. The link for STL files and necessary materials is below the video. Thank you for watching.